Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to use the mixing controls and plugins in PreSonus Studio One. We'll go over adjusting some of the things such as the volume and panning, as well as grouping our tracks and using sends to edit tracks together. In our previous videos, we looked at recording and editing audio and MIDI. Before continuing, make sure you've checked out the previous videos in the series and subscribe to the channel so you're notified whenever a new video is released. Let's start off with some of the basics. To be able to access the mixing controls, we need to bring up the mixer window. There's a mix button we can press in the bottom right corner to bring it up. We can click that button again to hide it and just bring it up again whenever we need to mix our project. From the mixer view, we can see each of our tracks and some basic controls for all of them. The top of the track is the inserts. We'll come back to this in a minute, but this is where we add our effects. Let's look at the bottom section. First, we have the input dropdown for our track, same as we had when we were looking at the project last time. Below that is the output for the channel. They'll usually be routed to the main output unless we need to add a send, but we'll go over that later as well. Below that is a small slider that goes left and right. This adjusts the left and right position of the track in stereo, so it's called the pan control. Below that, there are two numbers we can click on. The one on the left is the volume for the fader down below, and the one on the right is the panning. This just gives us a little more control than the fader or knob can give us by typing in the numbers. Below we have four buttons: mute, solo, record arm, and input monitoring. These are the same as we saw in the past videos from the other tracks view. On the right side, we'll see an extra track. This is the master track that everything goes through, and it has a lot of the same controls as a single track, but controls everything going through it at once. Now let's cover how to add a plugin onto our track. Plugins are found in the Browse panel on the right side of the screen. We can bring this up with the Browse button in the bottom right corner. At the top menu, switch to the Effects panel. Under PreSonus, we'll see the effects that are available to us to use. With the free version of the software, we don't have access to many effects and we can't add anything on our own. These are features that are reserved for the paid version of the program. There are two main plugins that we'll want to use for mixing in Studio One, and they're very basic. Those are the Channel Strip and Mix Verb plugins. To add a plugin, drag it onto a track under the Insert section. We'll see that the plugin is now on that track and it pops up. Close the window for now so we can talk about some of the controls for managing our inserts on the track. The top power button next to inserts turns all the plugins on and off for that track. When it's blue, they are working and change our sound. When it's gray, they are turned off. We can also do this individually for each of the plugins. If we right-click a plugin, we can also remove it. Double-clicking a plugin will bring the window back up and allow us to control it again. One of the other ways to control a plugin is through a send. A send sort of acts like a split off of the signal from a track. That means that the track still goes as it is to the master output, but a separate signal is duplicated and goes to another track. What this allows for is a few tracks to be combined on that track and effects to be applied to it together. This is usually done with something such as reverb, and that's how we'll set it up in this video. To do this, right-click to the right of our tracks and select Add Effects Track. Click and drag the Mix Verb Reverb plugin onto this track. Now we need to actually send some other tracks to this track. On the far left of the mixer panel, we'll see a little wrench tool to open some settings. Click on this. Here we need to make sure Sends Cue Mix is checked off, that way we control the sends on our track. Now we'll go to a track that we want to go to the send. Press the plus button and now select the effects track that we just created. Below that, now we have a little blue bar and we can drag this left and right to turn down and turn up the level of that track that is being sent. Of course, the volume of the send can be adjusted from its fader, but this allows us to adjust the blend of the tracks that are going to the send. So if we have a guitar and a snare drum and want more applied to the snare, we can have a higher level on the snare send than the guitar send. Then we can adjust the overall volume of the send effect from the effects track fader. One more thing we can do is group our tracks together to adjust them all at the same time. To do this, hold down Shift and click on each of the tracks you want to group and select them. Then right-click on the track and select Group Selected Tracks, then name the group. Now any changes or plugins that are added to all of them. If we right-click it again, we can click Dissolve Group to undo this group. Keep in mind that when you create a group, the changes that are only applied afterwards, so it doesn't automatically copy a setting to another track that was there before the group was created. Thanks for checking out this video on mixing tools in PreSonus Studio One. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for social media links to see all our new content.